Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston, this is Station. We're ready for the event.
Wunderschön, nicht wahr? Wunderschön, nicht wahr?
Was? Was?
Der Sonnenaufgang, der Sonnenaufgang. Fantastisch, fantastisch.
als ich mit einem Herrn von Belcom sprach und wir diskutierten über die Lüge. Alles, was er mir erzählte, war anders als das, was uns bislang erzählt wurde, bezogen auf die Wahrheit. Und an einem bestimmten Punkt fragte ich ihn, also Leute, ihr habt über eine Menge bislang gelogen, nicht wahr? Und sofort sagte er, nein, wir haben nicht nur über einige Dinge gelogen, wir haben über alles gelogen. Nichts davon entsprach der Wahrheit.
Mit ihm fing alles an. Sputnik, der erste Satellit der Menschheit. Am 4. Oktober 1957 wurde er von Baikonur aus ins All geschossen. Seitdem hat sich die Verkehrsdichte in unserer Umlaufbahn erheblich erhöht. Wie viel Weltraumschrott in den letzten Jahrzehnten dazugekommen ist, der unseren Planeten umkreist, zeigt nun der britische Forscher Stuart Gray in einer beeindruckenden Animation. Abgebrannte Raketenteile, Satelliten außer Dienst und anderer Schrott. Die NASA gibt die Zahl der Trümmer, die größer sind als ein Tennisball, mit 20.000 an. Sogar 500.000 Objekte gibt es, die mindestens so groß sind wie eine Murmel. Und Millionen weitere, die zu klein sind, um sie zu orten. Gefährlich können Trümmer in jeder Größe sein, denn sie bewegen sich mit einer Geschwindigkeit von über 27.000 Stundenkilometern. Und so musste die internationale Raumstation ISS im Sommer auch eine Kurskorrektur vornehmen, um nicht mit Weltraumschrott zu kollidieren. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey everybody, what's going on? This is ODD. I wanted to touch base on the results of the election, of course. First off, I just want to admit that I was wrong in my previous predictions of Hillary being the chosen one. I've said it a few times, many of us were wrong. I can't say I'm shocked or even upset. All I can say or ask is, what are they really up to? I am absolutely relieved that Hillary did not win. Even though I predicted it, it's not like I was hoping she won. Because she is 100% on board with the New World Order agenda, without any doubts whatsoever. She's a member of the Council on Foreign Relations. She was on the board of directors for Walmart, and she was even an honorary member of Skull and Bones. Not to mention numerous other connections and ties to organizations and think tanks that are leading us into the openly one world government order. So again, what are the puppet masters really up to? Would they really let Trump win if he's truly an outsider or has the capability to make real changes for America? I honestly don't think so. I'm certain that the powers that be have this all covered. Hillary could have been selected, but she could face criminal charges and go to jail at any moment. Trump can easily be assassinated at the convenience of the Illuminati. In fact, there's an interesting card from the 1995 Illuminati card game that has a striking resemblance to Trump, and it says, "Enough is enough. At any time, any place, our snipers can drop you. Have a nice day." It looks like Trump, we can't deny that. The thing about the Illuminati cards is that they have certainly predicted other events specifically. They've also predicted vague situations like Alex Jones on the Agent in Place card. These cards are not to be taken lightly. The assassination of Trump is a real possibility if he is some sort of rebel to the establishment and attempts to make positive changes. But I have my doubts. No matter how we chop it up, the man has been a part of sitcoms, reality TV, and movies since the 1980s. He even owned Miss USA, Miss Teen USA, and Miss Universe from 1996 to 2015. He's part of the media bread and circus, and that's all there is to it. This election could have gone either way, and it's still going to play into the agenda. My friend Nicholson1968 has a theory that when too many people catch on, you know, to their plans, they can change them in a split second in a way that still suits their needs or goals. I'm not trying to make excuses for why I was wrong, because I was wrong and that's that. Most of us were, and that's okay. They pulled an old switcheroo on us. I gotta say that I am pleased that we don't have to look at Hillary's face on a more permanent basis, but I can't say I'm thrilled about Trump. This was clearly a joke from the beginning, and it's really not over yet. We will see what happens in the coming months. One thing is still obvious, the election system is rigged. They always make it such a close race, and they do it on purpose to fortify the division of the people in your own mind. They want you to feel split and divided. So whatever this is, I believe it's on purpose. I just didn't expect it or see it coming. Maybe after the cover of the November 14th Time became available, we should have seen it. The cover is blasted in red, with Hillary wearing all white as if to symbolize giving up, while they both hold a sign saying the end is near. If they meant that the end of the election is near, then why is it a post-election Time magazine issue? Shouldn't it have been released before the election was over? That's how I feel, anyway. Either way, crazy times we are living in where anything can happen at any time. So be vigilant and don't put all of your eggs in one basket. For all we know, this is all leading up to Obama remaining as the puppet in office. We just never know. So that's all I wanted to say. Thanks for listening.